Hey, what's up, everybody? You're watching the Sit Down. I'm DJ Sixsmith. Look who's here. Tichina Arnold. How are you?
Hey, what's up? What's up? What's up? Hey.
You have been ready for this moment your whole life. Doing your thing. Good vibes. I see the sign on the back there. You're rolling right now.
Yeah, it's a shame, but I feel bad when people, you know, call me and they're like, how are you doing? I'm like, I'm great. Because I'm a Cancer and I've been planning for this for a long time. I'm kind of as sociable as I am. I'm also a hermit as well. So I love being home. I'm with my daughter 24/7. So that's different. But other than that, I'm good.
So how are you passing the time? Are you guys watching stuff, reading? I mean, what's been filling up your time?
Well, I've been trying to help her keep up with her studies, but that's kind of dead in the water. I mean, yeah, that's, I kind of gave up on that last week. My dog keeps following me around. She's not used to me being home all the time. So I'm like, why does this dog keep following me around? Because she misses her mommy. But I'm actually adjusting. I've been telling people, you know, this is a trying time, but this is just a moment. We're going through a moment and we're going to get through this moment. And that moment is not so much the quarantine. It's not the virus. It's not the actual bad part of what we're going through. The good part and the good moment is being able to do things like rest, like talk to family, reconnect with your children, you know, discover things in your house, you know, dust bunnies. You're finding new dust bunnies that you know, dust areas that you didn't know existed. This is a moment where we can really use the time wisely and effectively so that when we do get through this, we'll come out okay.
Yeah, no question about it. And there's also a ton of time to watch stuff, and including your new movie, Clover. So what was it like doing that? You had some pretty funny lines in that one, too. What was the best part of putting it together?
Oh, my gosh. I think I love the marriage between WWE and Netflix. And for me to be in a byproduct of that marriage is kind of cool. I play a grandmother, which I wasn't excited about it at first. I'm like, a grandma? Oh, come on, man. But I'm a grandma of an 11-year-old beautiful kid named Seth Carr. And he plays Leo Thompson in the main event. And we just had so much fun. I love the fact that it's a movie that we can actually be in quarantine together and watch it, and the whole family can watch it and really enjoy it. So that's the good part.
Definitely. And for you, like, you've seen all these different iterations of TV and movies. I mean, we have stuff that's coming out right away. We got shows that people are binging. What's it been like for you to adapt to this over the last few years?
It's been a slow roll, like, because I know, like, with the virtual stuff happening, I'm okay. I'm pretty good when it comes to adapting to environments, adapting to change, because I try to welcome change as best as I can. But to be able to, you know, you and I wouldn't be speaking right now had it not been for coronavirus.
Yeah.
So it's making the best out of what we've got. But people have been laughing at me in my interviews because I'm like, before I started interviewing with you, I was like this. Oh, I gotta do this. Like, so I'm like a mad woman trying to make sure, you know, my house is clean. Like, yep. This is just, it's a little invasive, but yep. It's cool. It's cool. And I'm just finding the fun in it. You know, you just gotta make the best of it. But I'm happy that people could be home and watch Martin. Everybody's watching, you know, reruns, which is cool. I have another movie coming out called Clover that's coming out this Friday, actually. So, yeah, I was like, great. I got two great films coming out, and everybody's on quarantine. So, this is cool.
What's it like for you having a whole new generation checking out Martin? Because obviously the people that were watching at the time loved it, but I'm sure you got a whole bunch of new people. So, what's that been like for you?
I've seen four generations watch Martin.
It's really? Wow.
Oh, man. I had a great-great-grandmother tell me that she watches
Martin. Amazing.
How cool is that? I realize that Martin is a sense of comfort for people because it's we've been in your homes for 30 years now. And that's a wonderful thing. That means we did our job right. So if we could come in your home and make you laugh, that's even better. Being on the neighborhood, it's a great show with Cedric the Entertainer and Jim Reynolds. We're able to have a show that is just a good, heartfelt show that comes from a real place. So we get to watch that, and I get to get a few residual checks on the reruns.
No bad deal, right? Thank you, CBS.
Thank you, CBS. But I think it's important that, which CBS has done, is they've created a new road for themselves, which is important. And I think it's inclusivity is very important. So I'm happy to be on, a predominantly Black show that is on a major network. Because a lot of people realize, they don't realize I hadn't been on a major network.
Really?
Which is kind of cool. Yeah. I was, when I did Martin was an independent, Fox was an independent network when Martin was on. So it wasn't, a famous network as of yet. And then Everybody Hates Chris was on UPN, which turned to CW. So I'm blessed. I am blessed to be able to still show my talents, have fun with people, meet people like yourself, and just kind of, we can all tell our stories because we ain't got nothing but time.
You mentioned Cedric before, and I've hung out with him a couple of times. What has been the most interesting part of working with him on a weekly basis?
You know, Cedric, I don't know how he does it all. Cedric literally is on the road on the weekends because he's a stand-up comedian as well, So Cedric has a lot of different hats. You know, he's a stand-up comedian. He's the actor. He's a producer. He's the father. He's the grandfather. He's the husband. He's the uncle. So working with Cedric and watching him interact with all of these people around him is really cool. He's still Cedric. He's Cedric to everybody. He's the same guy. He's just a really, really, really nice guy that I've known for very long, but we never worked with each other. I was like,
when did you guys first meet?
Oh God, I don't remember when I first met Cedric, but I know that it was in the 90s and no telling, in the 90s, man, I was doing a lot of stuff.
it's one of those relationships that it turns into a working relationship all these years later.
Well, yeah, I was during that era where HBO was putting out all these comedians, you got a special on HBO, you were a hit. So it's here I am, I've worked with Chris Rock, Martin Lawrence, Will Smith, I've worked with all of these amazing icons, and now I get to work with another icon, Cedric, and I'm so happy that Cedric has made his home on CBS, because CBS also needed us as well. It's a wonderful.
I would agree with that, too.
CBS needed this, and I'm good, and they're showing inclusivity behind the camera as well, so I like that CBS is putting their money where their mouth is.